Hi there, I'm Ashlyn with Fixed VIT, and welcome back to our series, Everything You Need to Know About SharePoint. Today we're going to learn how to attach SharePoint files to our Outlook emails. If you're looking for a specific section of this tutorial, you can find it by hovering over that progress bar below and selecting the section you need. And with that, let's get started. First, let's walk through how to attach a file straight from SharePoint. To start, we'll head over to the specific file in SharePoint. I recommend sharing just the file and not the entire folder for security reasons. Let's say I accidentally save something very private in this folder. Well, anyone with the link to the folder is not able to view that super sensitive information. So that's why I only attach the specific files. Okay, here we go. We want to attach this file. Hover over it and you'll notice a little share icon right next to it. When we click that, a box will pop up with all sorts of options. I want to draw attention real quick to this option. This controls who can access the document through the link we share. I have it set up where only people at Fixed VIT can view this document. However, I also have the option of allowing specific people or only people that already have existing access. You might have the option where anyone with a link can access it. This comes with potential security risks, so I highly recommend you avoid this option unless absolutely necessary. You'll also have the option to allow editing. If this box is unchecked, it will be a read-only document for anybody that receives it. Let's apply that and go back to this screen. You can share by adding someone's email here, which will send an automated email to that person. But let's say we want to attach it to an email with some more information. So we're going to click on the Outlook button at the bottom here. This will open our Outlook in a new tab. As you can see, it's attached a live link to that file. We can add a recipient, subject, everything in a normal email, and send it. When the other person receives this email, they can click that file and it'll open in the SharePoint web app. Now let's walk through how to do the same thing, but on our desktop app. If we head over to Word, I already have the same file open. If you look in the upper right-hand corner, you'll notice the same share icon we saw earlier. Click that, and hopefully everything looks familiar. Once again, when we click that, a box will pop up with all sorts of options. This controls who can access this document through the link we share. And let's apply that and go back to this screen. You can share by adding someone's email here, which will again send that automated email to them. We can also attach it to a pre-written email. So this time, let's click the Copy Link button. Now we'll head over to Outlook and create a new email. Paste that link into the body of the email. It should initially be a SharePoint link, but we'll reconfigure it to look like an attachment. Finish up the body of your email, and you're all set. When the other person receives this email, they will click that file and it'll open in the SharePoint web app. Next, we'll walk through how to attach a SharePoint file directly in Outlook. First, let's open an email we want to add the file to. Then we'll click the little paperclip icon towards the bottom. This gives us a few options, including some recent files we worked on. If the desired file isn't here, we can also click Browse Cloud Locations and navigate through our groups to find that file. You'll click it, add it, and it's ready to send. Finally, if you want to share a copy of a SharePoint file with somebody without giving them access to the original, it's also really simple. Let's find a SharePoint file we want to copy. To do that, we'll again go down to the paperclip icon below, and then find the file by selecting Browse Cloud Locations. Again, we'll go through the Group section to find the file we want, and then select it. Then we'll click the arrow to the right of the attached file, and select Attach as a Copy. This will create a separate copy of the SharePoint file, which will then be sent to your recipient. Any edits they make to their version will not affect your version. And that's all I have for you in this section. Check out our SharePoint playlist for other tutorials, and if you still have any questions, feel free to reach out to our team here at Fixed VIT. Thanks for watching!